Growing up in Flatbush as a youngster, I sometimes took for granted just how well we had it back then. The one constant, however, is the more things change, the more they stay the same. Many of us whom haven't seen nor heard from one another in over 2 to 3 decades came together like we'd been in a bubble, a vacuum, transported back to a time of young innocence exploding onto the Flatbush landscape. Flatbush, our home, our hood, is more than just a pimple in the borough of Kings. It was then and still is the cradle of our upbringing. Yes, I know. There are other neighborhoods throughout the borough of Brooklyn with reputations that far exceeded that of our community. Conversely, however, where else in our day could you find the Boys Club, the PAL, and the YMCA all in one neighborhood? What other community had Sears, Woolworths, and Macy's all within walking distance of the biggest high school in the city? We had so many movie theaters, the Albemarle, the Kenmore, the Astor, the RKO, the Biltmore, Regal, the Glenwood, the Granada, the Regent, the Rialto, and the granddaddy of them all, the Kings, still standing, a mammoth monument to a time all but forgotten. From Church and Flatbush, down to Clarendon Road, over to Nostrand Avenue, back up to Church Avenue, over to Flatbush Avenue again, forms a near-perfect box which we called home. From 22nd to 29th Streets, Cortelyou, Beverly, and Albemarle Roads, Erasmus, Woods, and Lloyd Street, Tilden and Snyder Avenue, Veronica Place, to Oakland and Lot, just boys on the block doing what boys do. All day b-ball games in Whitman, coming home musty, dirty, and sweaty was all we thought about most of the time, until we began to notice all the bootylicious girls with pigtails and braids in their hair. Hopscotch, jacks, scully, punchball, handball, stickball, ring-olivio, run-catch-and-kiss, horse, spin the bottle, and the ever-famous truth dare consequences promise or repeat. Do you remember? We boast of singers, dancers, DJs and rappers, and even 2 bands that played. Suckers and jivers and would-be MacGyvers, but oh, how much money we made. Yes, movers and shakers and true money makers was all some of us would ever be. But when it came to home, not far we'd need roam, for Flatbush was all we could see. We even had our own version of Harlem Nights. Remember Don's, Joint Connection, Screen's Mean Machine, big cars double parked on Bedford Avenue from one end to the other, silk suits, wingtip shoes, women dressed to the nine. We were the black version of West Side Story. Remember the ex-Vandals, the Jolly Stompers, gang fights, and all? But no one ever really got seriously hurt. There were, however, a few of us who did pass on for one reason or another, and to them we say, rest in peace, for although you are gone, you'll never be forgotten. And then, there was the one constant that glued us all together, the respect we had for our elders. Flatbush was mother and father to us all. You couldn't go too far before you ran into someone's parent. And you better not be doing something you shouldn't be doing, because by the time you got home, your goose was cooked, and you wouldn't even know how the hell your mother and father found out about it. My mom gave me the 1-2s on so many, 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 many occasions. But it was still then, just as it is now, the respect given that I remember most. I could go on and on and on, but I'm sure you all get the picture. I'm sure you all remember. It wasn't just growing up in Flatbush that made us all special. It was the togetherness and the camaraderie that we formed throughout our years. We went to the same schools, walked the same streets, danced to the same music, shopped at the same stores, played together, laughed together, cried together, but most of all, we were just together, as we are here today, reminiscing about the past and celebrating the now. God bless and keep you all.